One way to make your business succeed is by creating an eye-catching, easily recognizable logo. But sometimes we don't have the creative juice for that. Good thing there are small businesses like OddPixels offering their services in logo design. Let's learn more about OddPixels with its graphic designer and brand identity designer, Rael Mendoza. Rael, good to have you on the Business Roadshow.
Hello, folks. Thank you for having me.
Rael, can you tell me what trends do you see are shaping the future of graphic design? I mean, are you seeing more gradients, more minimalist, 3D design? What is the in-trend design nowadays?
I think more on vibrant color ang napapansin ko sa mga nagte-trend ngayon. Kasi yun ang talagang pinaka-catchy pagdating sa mga consumers. Parang nasa nature na rin kasi ng Pilipino yata na very festive ang natin, ang culture. Kaya in the terms of colors, medyo yung mga vibrant color, fun, festival, yun talaga ang parang napapansin ko na madaling mag-trend or usually hindi nawawala sa trend and talagang consistent siya na nakaka-pansin ng mga consumers.
And now, how do you envision the role of AI and technology also involving in graphic design?
I think for the AI, talagang na siya, magiging part na siya ng industry, especially in the generative AI. Kasi talagang this is a new technology that talagang pinag-aaralan pa kung may regulate. Dapat may regulate to since sometimes may mga copyright issue. Pero this will be a new skill of the new designer or the new generation of designer na talagang dapat nilang may adapt because especially talagang will be part of the industry soon. Hanggang now, ngayon, in the future.
Now, we all know that in the Philippines, it's teeming with graphic designers because of, Filipinos are known to be creative and very much involved in the arts. But how does OddPixels differentiate itself from other graphic design firms in the Philippines?
Usually, maraming magagaling na graphic designer or graphic design firms no, in our industry. Guru, I want as a new in the industry or sabi natin na newcomers, we are technology adaptive and then syempre nandoon pa rin yung creativity and magiging usually talagang magiging kami more on uniqueness from the word of the name of Odd, which is eccentric siya or something. Yeah. Centric. Yun nga, parang we want to focus on the uniqueness. So, yan ang magiging namin.
And because, you are talking about focusing on the uniqueness, I mean, as also the brand identity designer, I mean, what key elements do you believe are important for creating a strong brand identity?
Usually for the strong brand identity or the logo is kailangan talaga more on simple, recognizable kung sino ba yung target market mo. Yung mga target audience mo, kunyari if you are in the food, syempre ma-recognize kagad nila you are in the food business, yung logo mo pa lang like that. And then mga remarkable symbols and mga memorable.
Yeah. Are there some colors? Sorry, go ahead.
Make it simple na parang madali lang maintindihan ng mga consumers kasi you're a business na kailangan ma-attract ang mga target market mo eh. Kaya make it simple that easy to understand the design.
Are there some patterns that you're recognizing? Like for example, for the food industry, they tend to use this certain color more. And how about for tech industries? There's a certain color. Do you see that kind when your customers come to OddPixels?
Meron naman. Usually, mga example for that food industry kasi relatable talaga. They are using red. Minsan yun ang mga pinipili ng client kasi nga mayroon siyang psychology impact din. Then for the tech industry, they are using calm color, like example, blue, light blue, mga ganon.
And how do you balance, you know, creativity, especially, you know, with the client's vision and brand requirements? Usually the client, they don't even know what they want for their logo. So how do you guide them through this process?
Usually, I ask them a brief question about lang rin naman ito sa business nila. Then, who is their target market? Minsan, it is a collaborative process naman eh. I will ask them what symbols they like, colors like that. Then, pagdating naman sa conceptual process, ako na lang rin yung bahala doon. Pero, I still ask them kung meron na ba silang existing na naiisip na isang element na gamitin, something like that. Or kung symbolism na meron silang gamitin, gustong gamitin, yan, I will ask that. Then I will do the job for the concepting process.
And what are some of the brands, aside from the ones that we've been showing, that you know really made its mark, that you would say that that's really by Odd Pixels?
Meron akong isang ginawan na ano na business logo. Especially, I'm a computer science grad, ano rin may background mm-hmm. So, yung parang ginawa ko to is tech store siya. So, yan din. More on pixels din yung element na nagamit ko sa kanya. If you, enhance tech stores, name. So, I use some pixel idea with that logo.
And lastly, I mean, what are the future goals, plans, projects for Odd Pixels design in the next couple of months or years?
Hopefully we grow as a since this is a starting business, hopefully we grow. We got more team and then we have a physical place to have an office, something like that. Then we will ayun nga, pinag-aaralan pa rin namin yung generative AI that will be talaga magiging part na ng industry. So we have to be adaptive in that new industry of AI. Kaya, ayun. There's a more plan, pero ayan muna yung mga naiisip ko na dapat we should become adaptive in the new trends and changing environment of the industry.
Exciting times ahead. Rael Mendoza, brand identity designer of Odd Pixels. Rael, thank you so much for joining us again.
Thank you so much, Nipo, for having me.